For my family, gotta build a legacy. I'ma be the man when I'm dead. Work too hard, I can't slip up, so I'm clutching tight on this leg.
Hey, what's up, everybody? CW Entertainment back with another MLB The Show 21. We're back with the New York Mets franchise in game number 2 versus San Diego Padres. We got a battle of two aces. Yu Darvish will be taking on Jacob DeGrom. We could be in for a pitcher's duel. See how this is going to end up happening. Darvish really isn't having the best year. He's got a 4 ERA something. And for whatever reason, they're talking about Noah Syndergaard. Noah Syndergaard is not pitching this game. It is DeGrom. So we'll see how this one ends up. Let's get into this game. Let's go.
Yu Darvish is on the mound for game 2. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, this guy's done a real good job on the year keeping the opponent's batting average down. Both righties and lefties coming into this one, hitting under 250 against this guy. He's been good all season long.
Jeff McNeil will lead us off in this one. Let's see if he can have a solid day today as he comes back to the lineup. Well, McNeil is in an 0-2 hole here. Let's see if we can bounce back. And we'll go chasing a high cutter. It'll be sent out there into right field. Right fielder will have no issues. And that should be out number 1.
Up to the yard today, looking to fight. Everything changes once the first pitch.
And Lindor crushes one right field. Back goes the right fielder. That ball must be way up there. He's going to jump high. He's not bringing it back. It is a solo shot for Francisco Lindor. Gets one off of Yu Darvish. And it is a 1-0 ball game. 3 home runs, 2 days, Frankie Lindor. Yes, sir. Told y'all, man, he's getting that swagger back. And this dude is back to smacking him out of the park. Let's get it.
Well, it's obvious they didn't change their scouting report after yesterday's game. He had 2 bombs yesterday and another one today. Hey, this pace can't continue, but he's going to ride this wave as long as he can.
Wasn't sure that ball was going to end up getting out of here. I mean, man, that thing was way up there in the air. But a great job by Lindor to be able to send it over that wall. And J.D. Davis will come up to bat. J.D. Davis in an 0-2 hole here, looking to find a way to bounce back out of this. And oh! A good cutter, man. That cutter moves so slow. We're going to end up going down on strikes. Oh, Pete's going to end up grounding that one out to Machado, and that'll end the top half of the first. It'll be a 1-0 ball game thanks to Francisco Lindor. Let's see if Jacob DeGrom will have a good day today. And let's take a look at DeGrom in 11 starts. He has had a decision in 8 of them, 7-1 on the year, ERA of a 1.52. The fact that his ERA is at a 0.5 in real life is just unbelievable. The dude is just killing it. But let's see how he fares today versus the Padres, and Tommy Pham will lead him off. Times just got to go right at these guys. The 1-2 to Tommy Pham. Blew it by him 1-on-1 inside right there. It was in the zone, so even if he didn't swing, he would have been out. And that was the first out of the ball game for DeGrom, and it's going to be a strikeout. Why would it be anything else? He was late on that one, too. We're looking for another strikeout. Let's see if we can get it here. A 1-2 pitch. Inside on him, and he'll go down on strikes. Back-to-back K's for DeGrom. That fastball's already working. Popping his glove at 100. All right, let's see if we can get him here. 2-2. Got him! Cranked it up to 102 on the gun. DeGrom got every bit of that one. Striking out the side. You love to see it. Let's get it. Let's see if our offense can keep getting some more run support for him. Before though, Gurriel and the Rosarena. By the way, as you guys just ended up seeing, Conforto has overtaken Bryce Harper for the starting right field position. So we'll see if we can hang on to that as the first pitch is high from Darvish. And the 1-0 will be lifted right to Machado. I guess we got a little jammed on that one. That'll be out number 1. Oh, we missed a cutter right down the pipe. He's gotten away with that pitch a lot, man. That thing just moves so slow. When he can throw a fastball at 96 plus, yeah, he got 98. You can crank it up there, man. It's hard. Yeah, we're looking to see if we can draw a walk here or if he'll give in here on a full count pitch with 1 out. What you got, Darvish? What you got? And he gives us that cutter yet again. However, we're on top of it. That'll be out number 2. 0-1. Lifted into center field, and a Rosarena will be sat down in a 1-2-3 inning. Tatis is way out there in center field. Why the heck would he be out there to catch that? 0-2 pitch from the ground, looking for 4 straight strikeouts to start, and he will. Down goes Machado, and really didn't put up a battle at all in that at bat. 3 strikes, and he's gone. first pitch to Hosmer is going to be pop foul. J.D. Davis looking to get there, and he will be. Be out number two here. We'll take it. That would get Hosmer down. So we won't strike out 27, but that's okay. We'll also take these outs. It's going to be a grounder to Lindor. We're getting the dude out anyway. And that will be a 1-2-3 inning here in the second. Padres being shut down pretty easily so far. See if our offense can get something going. McCann, DeGrom, and the lineup will turn around with McNeil coming back. Full count pitch. Let's see if he ends up walking DeGrom. And he'll miss inside with that slider. DeGrom will be on base. We'll take it. As the lineup turns back around. And Jeff McNeil, oh my goodness, explodes on that one. That one's going to stay fair. It's a two-run home run and a 3-0 Mets lead. Seventh on the year for Jeff McNeil. And Yu Darvish gets burned by that cutter yet again. He's been throwing that thing down the plate the entire game. We've just been in front of it the entire time. Now, we were in front on that one as well. Luckily for us, it was able to stay fair. But Jeff McNeil obliterating that one.
Well, he's given up two long balls in just 2 1/3 innings of work. So it seems as though they might have his number here. Not sure how much more the manager wants to see. He needs to turn it around quick if he wants to stay in this one for a while.
Well, I don't know how long he'll be out here, but hopefully we can get on top of Darvish. He's showing why his ERA is in the fours. We fouled that one off with Lindor. The 0-1. And that one will be ripped fair. Wow, thought it was going to be going foul. But it'll be a single for Lindor. He's 2-for-2 today. That'll bring up J.D. Davis. And well, before that, they'll get a word to Yu Darvish from the pitching coach. Well, we're in an 0-2 hole here. Let's see. We can battle back. Come on, J.D. And he'll send a slider out there into right center field. I don't think they're going to be able to get that one. Grisham is not. The right fielder is not. It's going to hop over the wall for a ground rule double. J.D. Davis puts men in scoring position with Pete Alonso coming up to bat. That would have battled back with 0-2. We may have been able to score right there with Lindor. Not sure. Don't know exactly where he was on the base path, but hey, we'll take it. And we got a real good opportunity to blow up Yu Darvish here. All right, a 1-2 pitch. And we're striking out because we're swinging like an idiot. Well, that'll bring up Gurriel. It'll be up to him to bring home the two extra runs. Let's not let Yu Darvish out of this, man. We allow too many starting pitchers to get out of these type of jams. Oh, excuse me. Conforto was up to bat. I don't know why I didn't know what the lineup was. That's on me. All right, Conforto, let's do some damage, big dog. And we had good timing on that. We were just underneath it. Dang, man, we had an opportunity to blow this one over. That could have easily been a 3-run home run. Yeah, that's real unfortunate. But we do take the 3-0 lead thanks to Jeff McNeil. Let's see what DeGrom can do as he faces the bottom of the order. The 0-1. Oh, boy. Spotting that changeup beautifully. All right, now can we get the punch out? McCann is calling for it inside top corner. Let's get it. The 0-2, and he'll strike through it. Nola goes down swinging, 1-on-1 on the gun. We didn't get the placement exactly where we wanted it, but it still worked out in the long run. Right now, it's looking good for DeGrom to get that eighth win to tie Urias for second. And that'll be smoked into right field. Grisham gets a piece of that one. And that'll be the first hit of the day for the Padres. I don't think we're going to have a good opportunity to be able to turn. Oh, we might be able to if DeGrom can hurry. 1-6-3, double play. Let's get it. Great job right there, DeGrom, and what the heck is that? Okay, look, I don't think I've ever seen a Padres mascot, but my goodness. We'll take the double play, though, in the third. Let's get it. The 0-2. We lifted Oppo. Back goes the right fielder, but it's going to end up dying out there. And that'll be another out for Gurriel. He's up for two today. Randy Arozarena back up to bat. 0-for-1 on the day. Flew out to what should have been to the center fielder. Tatis Jr. went way out there to go catch that one. And it'll be a nice 2-0 count for Arozarena. Well, let's see if we can do some damage here. All right, here we go. The 3-0 to Randy Arozarena. He has the green light. And oh my goodness, we crushed another cutter, but we are out in front. Well, can he pitch in the zone again? The 3-2 count. He was able to work it back. And he'll miss. He couldn't throw three straight strikes. And Arozarena will easily walk. And in a 2-1 count, let's see if he can get something from Yu Darvish. We do. We sent it Oppo right field. Unfortunately, it's right at the right fielder. Didn't have much carry. And how to bring up Jacob DeGrom now with two outs. All right, well, DeGrom is a full count with two outs. Can you put one in play or will he walk again? The pitch from Darvish. Outside, he's going to be another Jacob DeGrom walk. We'll take it, his second of the day. Let's see if they keep Yu Darvish out here. The 1-1 to Jeff McNeil. Ah, we're going to hit it right to Tatis. Good timing on that curveball. Just happened to be right at him. Yep, that'll get Yu Darvish out of the top half of the fourth. He's lucky he didn't surrender any more runs. But so far, the offense, you know, we're looking good. We're leaving some guys on base, unfortunately. But we got DeGrom on the mound in a 3-0 lead. I like our chances. Top of the lineup returns as Tommy Pham leads them back off. And Tommy Pham sends one out to left field. Get foul, get foul, get foul. And Will, man, just clanked it off that brick wall up there. No one from DeGrom. Oh, boy. Well, we deserve that one. Luckily, that one didn't get at the park. It'd be a perfect base hit for him, but that was a bad changeup we threw. Missed the meter big time. Lifted into right field, Conforto will be there. And that should be out number one. He makes the grab. Get to the cutoff, man. And we got to get two more guys out of here in the fourth. But the runner's taking off. Tatis keeps it, and we're not going to be able to get him. We threw the slide step pitch last time. We didn't do it this time. And Tommy Pham is in there with his 14th stolen base on the year. Had a good jump on us. Fortunately, we didn't have the best throw. A better throw may have got him. I don't think it would have, though. Looking to set down Tatis, the 1-2. And, oh, he got the grounder we were looking for, unfortunately. That's going to move the runner over, but unfortunately, he made that stolen base. That is going to pay off big for them at this point. Let's see if we can get Machado, though. The 2-2. Machado can't catch up to it. See you later. Another strikeout for Jacob DeGrom. This dude is electric, man. He is electric. It'll remain a 3-0 ball game. Machado was extremely late on that one. Lindor back up to bat 2-for-2 today versus Yu Darvish, including the solo shot home run that got us going. The 1-0. And we're going to weekly chop that. Man, how did we just get... Come on. All right, J.D. Davis came up the bat, got a ground rule double last time. Unfortunately, was not able to come home. Let's see what he can do in the top of the fifth. And he'll ground one over to Machado, third baseman, getting out. Osmond's being a pain in the ass here. Another 0-2 from DeGrom. He'll go down anyway. You should have went down the last three pitches. But it's okay. We got the strikeout anyway. Jacob DeGrom showing why he's the league leader in strikeouts. Let's get it. An 0-2 pitch to Myers looking for the strikeout. See you later. Three pitches and he has gone down easily. Oh my goodness, Jacob DeGrom. It's just unfair. It is unfair to be able to pitch with DeGrom. I mean, my goodness. Looking to strike out Nola on three pitches as well. The 0-2. Oh, that one's lifted into left field. Gurriel got to get on the move over there and he'll be there in time to get the final out in the fifth inning. Great rundown right there by Gurriel. And he'll also lead us off to start the sixth. And that will do it for Yu Darvish. He made it through five innings. Does get a quality start. We couldn't chase him. We should have been able to chase him a little sooner. That's all right. Craig Stammen enters the game. 3.5 ERA. Nothing too, you know, we're not worried about too much out of this game. 2-1. And that is going to be grounded weekly to the third baseman. And Gurriel will go down. Well, we're in 0-2 hole with a Rosa Arena. And a Rosarena will do get a very solid hit right there with a ball well out of the zone. He'll be on base for the second time today. And we'll take it. Man, that ball was way down there. I think it was a little bit lower than what that was showing. And oh, a Rosarena got picked off. Wow. Man, that is so broke. Like, you can lead off. Like, you can't control that. Like, in Road to the Show, you can control them getting back. On here, I don't think you're able to control that. Well, that's it for Rosarena. The 1-2 to Grisham. And he's going to get caught looking at a slider. We missed the meter pretty badly on that one, but it also worked out for us. And he'll go down. Strikeout number 9 for DeGrom. And it'll be lifted. Oh, into left field. Tatis couldn't jump up there to get it. He's not like the Diamondbacks center. Not center field. The shortstop. That dude was catching everything. We're in 0-2 hole with McNeil. And he'll send it right back up the middle. Second baseman not going to be able to get that one. And that's back-to-back base hits. Looking good so far here in the top of the seventh inning. Well, we've done our damage versus guys with two strikes. So let's see if we can keep going. The 0-2 to Lindor. And that'll be sent out there into right field. Back goes the right fielder, still going back. Back all the way to the wall. He'll go way up there to catch it. Very, very close to again. That was almost like the exact same thing that happened with his first home run. That ball just kept carrying. We do have 6 mile per hour wind blowing in the face. So that could be a reason why, but that one was way up there as well. And that'll bring up JD Davis. All right, JD, let's see if we can come up big, man. Got men on the corners. We at least got to get one home. And JD grooves one into left center field. Back goes the center fielder. He's going to be able to get there in time. Unreal. Thought that one may have got up out of here. Think that wind blowing in did not help us on that one. But it will bring home another run as it's a sacrifice fly. Grisham made a good job getting all the way out there. I was really hoping he ended up missing getting that one. And that ball barely got to the track. Route efficiency, 96. Good grief. The 2-2 now. Got him looking at a curve. I mean, not a curve ball, but a slider. Backdoored him. See you later. Crowing word goes down again. It's his third time being out. Yo, to the Tatis. Oh, we missed with that one. But fortunately, that one's just going to be lifted right over there to Rosarena in center field. That's not what we wanted that fastball to him. But it will end up being an out. Here we go. Another full count pitch. And he'll pop it up to shoot. McCann will be there in foul territory. It'll be yet another 1-2-3 inning for Jacob DeGrom. The Padres have been shut down to this point. The 0-1 will be lifted over there into left field. That'll be a base hit. We'll take it. Tommy Pham gets it back to the infield. Good job, Conforto. Having a pretty good series so far. And Gurriel is going to roll this one into a 4-6. It's going to be a double play. It will be. Ah, man. Gurriel has not had the best start to his series. 2-2 looking for the K. Going to be grounded to Lindor over there. He's got plenty of time to make a good throw, and he will. Brown just needs to get two more outs to end this eighth inning. He can leave this game with a good shot at getting the win. And it wasn't even close. DeGrom, 10 strikeouts. Yu Darvish only gave up 4 hits, but he walked 4 people as well. What a strikeout again. Here we go. Another 0-2 to Will Myers. He'll go down. Strikeout number 11 for Jacob DeGrom. See you later, Will. The 0-1 to Nola. And oh, that ball's groomed. Left field. Gurriel's got to get back there in time. He will not. And that is a home run given up from DeGrom. Well, I really don't like throwing two seamers. I've decided, hey, we're going to throw them maybe once a day. And that one gets crushed. That is some boogle. All right, DeGrom bounce back, strike him out, and you can retire for the rest of the day. He'll strike him out 3 pitches. See you later. The slider was nowhere in the zone. Should have just left the pitcher in it. They were going to do that. And McNeil, oh, what a play by Hosmer at first base. Looked like McNeil was going to be 3-for-5 today. That ain't our half for the ninth. Let's see if Diaz can shut it down this time.
Shut it down, down, down. You shut it down, down, down. You be the best.
1-2 from Diaz, trying to find a way to put him out, and he will get him out. Slider busted him inside. See you later.
He was on point from the get-go this evening.
No left field. Yeah, he looked really dialed in from start to finish. This is the kind of outing you hope for every time you go out there.
Not hitting our zones too well with Diaz, but hopefully we can find it right here. The 0-2 crush out there. That was a perfect hit. The Rosarena should be able to get there in time, and he will for out number 2. One more guy to get. The 1-2 from Diaz looking for the strikeout. Going to get a grounder. McNeil will be there. He'll have plenty of time to get the out, and that'll do it here in this one. 4-1 is your final as the Mets get yet another win on the year. See, that is win number 43 or 44, something like that. We're on the road, man. I believe it's 43. We're on the road once again. Padres, they are in a bad stretch right now, and it's clear. They only got one run in the last game. They got one run this game. Their offense has right now just been shut down by our pitching staff. We know our pitching staff is elite. DeGrom also gets the player of the game. 8 innings pitch, only 3 hits given up. 12 strikeouts, 0 walks. I don't gave up the one run. Unfortunately, they did get a home run off of him. But right now, we are trying to find our groove again. We're on a 3-game win streak. So hopefully, you know, we'll end up being able to get this 4-game sweep versus the Padres. Their offense is just not showing up versus our pitching staff. And thank you all very much for watching. If you guys did enjoy the video, make sure you guys hit that like button. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what you thought. Hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with this New York Mets franchise and more that we'll be posting to the channel. I'm out till next time, everybody. Hope you guys stay safe out there. I'll catch you in the next one. And as IMAF says, God first, God bless. Peace. Close it out, future. And it's the love from my fans got me still here.